Nishan Prakash for giving us this interview for Indus Scrolls. We are feeling really privileged for this, and I'm sure this is going to enlighten many, many students who are going to enroll for law courses. Sir, after 8 years into a law firm, how did this Nishan Prakash law classes happen?
So, basically, I used to be a corporate lawyer. I've worked with a couple of law firms, possibly the best law firms of the country, right? So, at a point of time, you need to see what exactly you want to do in life, right? So, if you are very satisfied with what you are doing, it's nothing like that, right? You know, the law firms are the best possible choices in the present scenario. But then again, possibly I didn't want to do what I was doing there. So, even though, you know, a very good career with the, you know, whatever you want in life, everything, a law firm caters everything you want to have in life. But then again, possibly I was looking to do something for the society as well, which was not being catered by my engagements there. So I thought of doing it. Second, the passion of mine towards teaching, right? So since I've graduated in 2011, I've always been teaching, right? But even while I was working with the law firm, the weekends it used to be free, or whenever I was free, I used to take classes at different places pro bono, so that I could interact with kids, and the experience actually was very fascinating for me. So later I decided to do what exactly gives me the kick. So I started teaching people. Second was, I was not very satisfied the way institutes and the education system has been commercialized, right? So that was something which used to trouble me because everybody is after most of these people have institutionalized the entire scenario, entire setup in the way that maximum money can be extracted from the people. So if you can start considering education as a business, then it becomes an issue, right? Then you come up with different brands, then you offer discounts. So we need to understand that this is not, education is not a business. We just have to do service to the nation, as well as, of course, Utana, you charge a minimal amount because you need to take care of your survivals as well. That is fine, because Guru Dakshina is something which has always been there throughout. If you go to ancient ages, people have been giving and asking for Guru Dakshinas, but that does not mean that you'll entirely make it a business. So that was the basic concept behind Nishan Prakash Law Classes, to cater something which is the requirement and not make it a business. Right? Yeah.
Okay. So there was a time when engineering and medicine were the most sought after courses, but these days there's been a lot of demand for law. And how do you think that it has become an attractive course these days?
I'll tell you, we stay in the second most populous country in the world, right? So we are too many. We are many. Hum log itne zyada hain, we all know about that, right? So it's not that engineering has turned out to be a bad career or medicine is a bad career, but then again, it's flooded now. There was a time when if you are good at maths, you become an engineer. If you're not good at maths, then you become a doctor. Even medicine was not the first choice, right? Medicine was also was, agar aap maths mein achhe hain, toh aap engineer ban jate hain. Agar aap maths mein achhe nahi hain, toh aap doctor bante hain. Teesra koi career nahi tha, right? But recent times, it has changed a lot, especially in metros. Even the toppers of people who jab aap 10th karte hain, when you come in the 11th standard, even the toppers of few batches I've seen, they are taking up humanities and commerce. That is a good sign, because we need to understand that it's not only engineers and doctors who are running the country. There are many professionals who contribute to the society, and that's how the entire society works in, right? But now recent times, it has been great that people are opting for different streams, and we are seeing good talents coming up in towards sector of law or wherever. So that is a good sign. Yeah.
We have heard a lot about your classes. Nishan Prakash coaching classes are supposed to be Gurukul. People can't think for the next 2 years about anything else other than your classes. So how did this? Why do they call it a Gurukul?
I'll tell you, right? So possibly, you know, the only factor and one of the strong factors which differentiates this place with others, that we have a limited intake, right? Problem is ki even the good teachers get driven by the greed factor, right? So the moment you have that greed coming into the scene, then you start taking people, and then you have numbers, and then if you cannot handle numbers at one place, then you start opening up centers, and this becomes a typical business, right? What we do here is we have a limited intake. I'll tell you, being a faculty, being a CLAT mentor, I can certainly tell you within first 2 months we get an idea how exactly is it going to treat somebody, right? Now CLAT is something, it's a very language centric exam, right? Now if you're not good at language, it would be a big problem for you to crack the course, right? Because language, we need to understand, English is not a subject, it's a language, right? And the sort of changes in the CLAT pattern this year have been, you need to have a very good command over language. So if I take 100 people, say Hotana, all from regional backgrounds and people who are not good at language, even though knowing that it will be very difficult for them to crack the exam, that would be an injustice from my part. That's what people are doing. They are recruiting everybody. They are taking up everybody possible. Around whoever comes to the center, they take them up, and they give you them an impression that they'll help him or her in getting through the examination. That is wrong. Right, even knowingly people are doing that just for the sake of money, which is very wrong. So what we do is we have a membrane wherein we select people whom to train and whom not to train, right? So we basically have an idea that who are the guys, who are the persons who will be able to make it to it. So we just take people who have the basic potential of getting through the exam, which English language is a bigger part. Yeah,
we also have heard about Super 30 in Bihar. He's very famous for his classes, and now you have been identified as Amirunga Super 30. Can you tell us, how did you become so famous with this tag, Amirunga Super 30?
I'll tell you that this Amirunga, there are a few journals and there are a few magazines. I don't know how this notion has come up with me, but there are a few magazines and few newspapers who came up ki Amirunga Super 30 and Naya Super 30 and CLAT ka Super 30 and all these things. I'll tell you, a system like Super 30, what Mr. Anand Kumar, who has been doing great, has set up, so that looks good for engineering or possibly for medicines, right? A Super 30 in CLAT is not possible, right? Because what happens there, that he picks people from modest background and he trains for a year or 2 years to get them through IIT JEE exam or whatever, right? Here the CLAT is mostly language centric, right? So if you give me students from modest background, it doesn't matter, modest background is a, I'll tell you, from regional boards who have not been studying English throughout. Now if you ask somebody to train them for the language and sort of language these exams ask for in 1 year, that would be a very difficult thing, right? So a Super 30 concept can work only for people who have done their schooling possibly from English medium schools or who have the basic understanding of English, wherein hum log basically uske jo language part ko groom kar sakte hain. If you give me few students who are not at all aware of what English is, and then you ask me to make or anybody to compete with the people who have been doing these things or reading comprehension or something like that throughout their life, then it becomes very difficult. So a Super 30 concept is possible in CLAT only if they are from they have the basic understanding of English. And here what happens that at our center, most of the students are from the good schools, or possibly we have students from Dune School, Wellem School, Sanskriti, Modern, Vasant Vihar, whatever the best schools of Delhi and India is. So it becomes a bit easy for me to train them because their language part is sorted. started. So we work on other parts, and that's how we are considering. Almost everybody from the center has been, you know, getting through all the top law entrances examinations till now. So they've started calling me Amiro ka Super 30, but it's not that. I only train people from good family background or people who are illustrious. It's just that these people come to us, so, and we train it because I never advertise myself, right? We just have a website because people ask. It becomes very difficult to, because for every small thing they used to call me and ask me what's happening and what's there and all. So just to cater those needs, I've come up with a website. Otherwise, I do not believe in advertisement. I do not believe in anything, and rather no advertisement, nothing. It's only word of mouth. The center is already flooded with people whom I find very difficult to, you know, handle them. So we have a restricted number of people. We have a limited number of people taking policy that will just train these people, and we'll try to do justice with them.
So, sir, and, this is COVID times now, and everything is online. So, do you think digital, education is as effective as classroom teaching?
Practically telling you, COVID, yeah, of course, these mobiles have saved our lives, right? And the internet has saved the world. Now I'll tell you, you know, it's effective, it's fine. Students don't have to travel to center. Say we are in Delhi, there are people who travel all the, like they, it takes 2 hours and 3 hours just to come to the center. So say if we have a class of 3 hours, so it technically 2 hours plus 2 hours is the traveling, so 4 hours is the traveling, and 3 hours, so it technically takes the entire day. That is one good part of the digital portion, that, you know, that is being catered. But second portion, which is an issue we need to understand, we are training kids, right? 11th and 12th kids are not that matured. Now what happens that, you know, the classes are on. Now the students have to be serious themselves. It becomes very difficult to test them, right? The moment you take a test, so you know, even though they are, you ask you to switch on their cameras, what happens that, you know, like somebody might be able to cheat, or somebody you know just disappears from the class saying there's an internet problem, right? So we don't get to know whether it's genuine or it's a fake, right? So students need to understand, they themselves have to be very, very, very you know, they have to understand that whatever we are doing, it's for them, right? ये हम लोग अपने लिए नहीं कर रहे हैं. They have to be very academically centric. They have to work hard. They need to understand that even if you try to bluff your teacher, then basically you are bluffing you, right? So that is something. And otherwise it's fine. But yeah, so at the same time, what happens that say they are like 60 people connected in a class, right? And they're like 5 people possibly जिनका internet failure हो जाता है. Now वहाँ पे एक बहुत बड़ा चीज़ होता है that you know, need to understand कि वो चला गया. Then again 10 minutes back they are back to the show again, and then they realize that we have considerably missed them. So it becomes a problem for the teacher as well, because you know it is so in a country like ours, jahan pe hum log bahut zyada abhi digitally equipped nahi hain, right? And isme aapko cheeze problematic ho jati hai hamare liye bhi, because if say 5 students are not there in the class, then how do you don't get to know ki kab kaun hai kab kaun nahi hai. So that is something you know, abhi I think we are not digitally prepared for online classes 100%, but yeah, these digital classes have been a savior for sure during the COVID times.
So what do you think about NLAT and CLAT rows happening right now? So do you think it's going to affect the students also?
So NLAT, so anyway, Supreme Court has this year they have told that you know NLAT will not sustain, but it created loads of harassment to children's minds, as in they were treated, they were nothing. There were two vice chancellors fighting out for what, God knows, but then again the resultant was very bad. Students had to take an extra examination which was of no use, right? So but then again that's fine, that has ended now. Now we have today, in fact we have come on a very right day, it's CLAT examination today, and we have also you know feeling very free, because now students are, it has been a very difficult past 1 month, because you know we also work with the students, right? So it's equally hectic for us as well. So now NLAT is over. We don't know what's going to happen for the next year. So possibly, you know, what we have been told that National Law School Bangalore will come up with a different examination, but that's not a very good sign, because if Bangalore can opt out from the examination, then other colleges might again, right? So that would result into, so there are 22 National Law Universities in CLAT. So, you know, students might have to face 22 exams. You never know. So that is not a very great sign. But then again, yeah, so that's how things are working on, considering these colleges. colleges are from state legislations. They have been created through different states. So all the colleges have the right to come out of the CLAT and start their own examination. But that's not a very good sign. Yeah.
So with the outbreak of this pandemic, what the government could have done, the best thing would have done, I mean, they could have done is the digital education. But what do you think the remote areas are doing? I'm sure they must be having a lot of problems. How do they reach out to you?
I'll tell you, it's not only about remote areas. Even in places like Delhi, even in places like Delhi, you cannot be, you know, even the examinations have happened. There are so many examinations which have been conducted. Right now, it's not digitally foolproof. Right there, we are, there was an examination for A-LATE, that's for NLU Delhi, which happened on 26th. Right, so there have been reported so many cases wherein there was a electricity failure, there was connectivity issues, there were software issues, because this time they have decided to take online examination. So basically, even in 2018, the CLAT conducted online examination that was a complete failure. So, but they were forced to conduct the same this time. But again, there have been instances of computer failure and you know, poor internet. So it's not a justice to you know, all the students. So I believe we are not equipped for online examinations till now, right? So I think for the time being, so that it's a justice to all the students, the government or the CLAT committee should restrict themselves to the paper mode. That's the basic mode. And once we are fully equipped with the online setup, then only we can, you know, go for the online classes, online examination. Yeah.
I have seen that there are more and more girls are getting attracted to law courses. So what do you think about it? Is it the right profession they are? Is it, I mean, many of the girls I've seen that they are attracted to even going as a criminal lawyers. Recently I've met a lot of people. So what do you think about it?
I'll tell you, you know, gone are those days wherein लॉयर्स को आप देखते के साथ सोचते थे कि वो एक काला कोट पहनकर और वो कोर्ट में घूम रहा है. और देयर हैव बीन सो मेनी मूवीज जहाँ पे लॉयर्स का बहुत बुरा हालत भी दिखाए हैं कि वो छाता के नीचे बैठा हुआ है. लाइक मूवीज लाइक क्योंकि मैं झूठ नहीं बोलता एंड दिस LLB जॉली LLB एंड ऑल, राइट? सो दैट्स नॉट द एक्चुअल स्टेट ऑफ लॉयर्स. इज व्हेन यू कम टू दिल्ली, इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट, राइट? आई टेल यू, द कॉर्पोरेट लॉयर्स और अस बेसिकली और एनीबडी हु इज वर्किंग ऑन द कॉर्पोरेट साइड, बिलीव मी, आई हैव माय फ्रेंड्स हु आर वर्किंग फॉर लॉ फर्म्स. दे हैव नॉट विजिटेड कोर्ट फॉर वन डे एंड दे हैव बीन लॉयर्स फॉर 10 days, राइट? दैट्स द साइड ऑफ कॉर्पोरेट लॉयर. और द क्रिमिनल साइड, ऑफ कोर्स, क्रिमिनल, व्हेन यू टेक अप क्रिमिनल साइड और द लिटिगेशन साइड, यू नीड टू विजिट कोर्ट्स. सो व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द कॉर्पोरेट सेक्टर, the corporate lawyers these days, they are one of the highest paid lawyers, right? So unke wajah se, so and that is something very, you don't have to visit courts or aapko kahin jana nahi hai. You sit in a air conditioned office and you just you know, make mergers and acquisitions ka deeds and things like those, right? So that is attracting girls a lot, because you know, the Indian mindset is like ki ladki logo ko bahut zyada nahi jaane dena hai and all those things, right? So that is being catered with a good lifestyle, right? Even towards the criminal law sides, you'll find many litigation, the girls who are getting interest because nahi hai that there's no, we'll see, if I studied with, say, our batch had 24 girls, so hum logo kabhi dimag mein bhi nahi aata tha that he or she is a girl or a boy. We were so free, right? So I believe that's way the national law school students and the good law school students are being groomed up. So, वो लड़का लड़की वाला difference is gone. And criminal law, अगर किसी को corporate, there are so many boys who are doing just corporate lawyer, they just do corporate law, and there are so many girls who do criminal law. So, gone are those days जब लड़का criminal law कर सकता है, लड़की ये कर सकती है. This is not national law school strain you basically. Yeah.
Sir, one last question is what is the kind of training one person has to do? Like, people do UPSC ki taiyari karte hain, so everybody knows that kabhi school se hi shuru ho jata hai, 8th se, 9th se. So what do you think, law is also now on par with that now? So when do they exactly start this, and what do you think, how can you motivate these children to get into this training?
My advice for all the students who want to pursue law as a career would be read newspapers every day. You need to be aware what's going around. You need to be aware ki duniya mein chal kya raha hai. You need to read good newspapers, right? Because I'll tell you, you need to have a good vocabulary. Because even though if you access few dictionaries like say Bhargav or Sahni, right? So these dictionaries are not apt, right? So just read the good newspapers, good journals. Newspaper reading is a must, right? Then you should read novels. The idea is that you have to be good at your language. Second point is, you know what happens that in a country like India, आपको हिंदी आए ना आए, अगर आपको इंग्लिश आता है तो आपका रोजी रोटी को तो कोई इफेक्ट नहीं कर सकता है. आप इसको खराब मानिए अच्छा मानिए, that's another feeling, right? That might sound थोड़ा सा एंटी नेशनलिस्ट, बट दैट्स अ फैक्ट एंड दैट्स हाउ थिंग्स आर वर्किंग. कि इंडिया में हिंदी बोलने वालों का कोई अभी ज़्यादा पूछ रहा नहीं है, सब इंग्लिश के पीछे भाग रहे हैं. सो दैट इज what the fate of this place is, right? So you need to have a very good language, you need to have a very good command over the comprehension skills. For that, again, reiterating what I said, English is not a subject, it's a language. It is only developed through years, right? It takes 5, 7, 8 years. So you should start reading newspaper as soon as possible, then go through good journals, be aware of what's happening. And for CLAT, I believe once you are done with your 10th and you need, you know that this is what you want to do, so 2 years of training is more than enough for CLAT. And people who are very good at English and general knowledge part, who have been reading newspapers, so the newspapers grooms you overall, so that makes your language better and that makes your general knowledge better. So if you are that kind of student, then even 1 year of training would suffice.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.